Hi everyone, just a quick mention of my book before today's video starts. Watercolour Painting Made Simple by myself, Stephen Cronin. Available on Amazon, hardback, softback, Kindle. So that's on Amazon. Details in the description below. So let me show you today's video. Hi folks, thanks for joining me again. Another watercolour demo. This one, sort of open land, bit of a hill in the distance, trying to get a dramatic sky. Simple little river flowing through, framed by a little tree. Lots of darks in the foreground to contrast with the light in the sky. So let's just dive straight into the painting. So it's quite a fairly straightforward looking landscape. So I want to really try and make the sky as dramatic as I possibly can. I'm going to start off with a bit of raw sienna and ultramarine, and then use various, start with a bit of light red and ultramarine, push this down, something like that, light red, pearl's grey. So I've got a few darks in, let's just go a little bit more. Down there. A bit more blue. Well, then I'll clean my brush. Just soften it up here and there. Mix it all together. Spin the brush again. As soon as it starts to get dirty, see a little bit of light under there. Again, clean the brush. And get a bit of light up there. A bit of a white cloud. Bit more light because I want the horizon to show up. Let's give that a quick dry. A bit bone dry, but just dry enough just to stop all the paint from coming down the paper. And then the next thing to do is get in some of the distant land. So I'm just mixing a lot of those sky colours together. Plenty of blue. And that's going to sort of something like that. And again, what I might do. Maybe just soften a bit of that off. Make it look as if the sun's coming down. Some dark tree line, really strong tree line. So I've gone lemon yellow, bit of ultramarine. Okay, let's start off with that. And switch to a bit of Payne's grey. It's the lemon yellow. And there, it's that Payne's grey again. Thank you. clean the brush. I'm going to go with a bit of white lemon yellow in there. Brush, yeah. Brush that side. Clean the brush. Try and get in. Take that out there like that. Back into some lemon yellow. Ultramarine in there. Clean the brush and blending those together there like that. Just take that out a little bit. Just switch it to a flat brush just to get out of. Thank you. Just switching to the flat brush, just adding a few little bits and pieces here and there. Oh, I'll go with the finger. This is just experimenting, really. Number three Riga. What a dark mix. Just using burnt umber, a bit of ultramarine. I'm just going to stick some of there, just give a bit of foreground interest, make that a little bit more darker. Whoops. Reloading the brush, bit of brown, bit of blue, nice dark mix. To the back to the high brush, bit of brown, bit of blue, just stick some up down there. That was just a quick scrape with the card. A little bird. Well, I'm going to call that one finished, I think. So I'm just going to stick my name. I'm going to pull that one done, so let's put a mount on it and see what it looks like.
So here's the finished painting the mount. We're going to have a closer look. Started off with the sky, tried to get lots of darks in and then used the height just to take out a few lighter areas in the sky, especially here. Kept this deliberately a bit lighter so that the tree would stand out a bit better. See the distant hills, varies from having sharp edges then into the sort of misty look. Same on the other side, just took the possibly a bit too much out. I would have preferred to have just left a little bit more so it was a bit more visible. And then in front of that I got this tree line, just use the corner of the hake just to brush that in using very dark green, lemon yellow, Payne's grey. And then sort of contrast against the lighter areas in the sky, got much of the ground area in really, really dark. And then the river just left that really light so that it stood out from the land. got a bit of rigger work down there, a few grasses, and then a couple of trees, big one here on the left, loads of little flicks with the the rigger brush. And then whenever I've put some darks in, can't resist a odd scrape with the cartilage to create a few rocks. So that's it for this one. I hope you enjoy that. Thanks for watching. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Just keep practicing, and I'll see you again soon.